movements within their within not only their own organizations, but also within the netizen community, and also to transcend the digital divide to make people far more informed about what is cybersecurity, how can people contribute. We have to appreciate, much that we would not want to talk about it, that there's a huge digital divide. And even in countries like India, there's a huge digital divide. How do you address them, and how do you carry with you that huge chunk of people who are below the digital divide? For them, instances or issues like this have no relevance or bearing on their day-to-day economic survival conditions. But at the same time, it's also important that the countries in this part of the world provide thought leadership. One way of giving thought leadership is to say, hold on, this is a new legislation, or this is the new approach that we are doing. Let's go about and propagate further. Now, to give an example about, say, cybercrime. Now, internationally, you just mentioned about an intervention about Council of Europe. Council of Europe has got its own treaty, the Convention on Cybercrime. Large number of developing countries, though, are in sync with the fact that the principles enshrined therein are extremely relevant in the context of this part of the world, but still do not have the political will to join them for a variety of reasons. Similarly, when you talk of privacy, the concept is non-existent in some jurisdictions, and the cultural and the sociological factors are such that you can't expect a very kind of a uniform approach. Let me give an example. You are here in India. India has got a law on information technology. It's known as the Information Technology Act 2000, but still it's not very proficient or eloquent on the issue of privacy. Is the concept of privacy existing? Yes. But today, when we are seeing more terror attacks, when terrorism is suddenly gaining center stage attention,